And one name keeps cropping up, EastEnders, in half an hour. First on BBC One and the BBC HD channel, entertaining ill children. We send in the clown.
Operation was successful, so the critical thing now is for your daughter to get absolute rest. No shocks or scares.
Dr. Plonky calling! I heard this little girl needs a prescription for chuckles!
For God's sake, please get out of here.
Oh, time to inject some humour into the situation!
Security!
Get that clown away from my child!
Oh, laughter's the best medicine! I'm only spreading some sunshine!
Okay, everyone. Actually, no, not everyone. Just you, Uncle Jeff. You are not to go within 500 yards of the hospital on pain of prosecution.
But, Lizzie, I'm working with critically ill children.
Yes, but they weren't critically ill until you turned up. Now they're spending £6,000 on security specifically to keep you out.
Wish we could afford to do that.
Did you hear that, Geoffrey? Because of you, that hospital's become more safe and secure.
Yes. Yes, it has.
All right, come on, Jeff. Superstar.
On the subject of security, we have a thief amongst us.
What?
Well, you have been to prison, Erasmus.
You are a known criminal.
You're a known clown. Doesn't mean you've ever done anything funny.
That's reasonable. Three crates of popcorn have gone missing and a candy floss machine.
That definitely wasn't me. I thought you were going to say the raffle money, which, by the way, I also didn't steal.
I'm afraid I'm the culprit. They're in my caravan.
What? What are you doing with popcorn and candy floss, Lizzie?
Well, I know it's going to sound weird, but I've been eating them. I really believe in this circus, and because we're struggling at the moment, I've stopped taking a wage, so I can't afford to buy any food.
Lizzie, if things are bad, we will all help out, right, guys? Hey, we can all take a pay cut, yeah? Let me hear you say yeah!
Boyko, it's very sweet of you, but how would you survive?
I could move into your caravan. I would eat the scraps from your plate and drink from your toilet, like a dog.
It's very kind of you to make that disgusting offer, but no.
That'll get us money easy. We are insured against fire, aren't we?
Yes.
Well, there you go. Problem solved.
No, I don't want you burning down the circus.
Got it. Best if you don't know anything.
No, Erasmus, listen to me. I do not want you to burn down the circus.
Absolutely. Received and understood.
No, I really, really don't.
Gotcha.
No, I honestly don't want you to burn...
Hey!
Geoffrey! What's happened? Is he dead?
I don't think so.
Let's bury him anyway, just in case.
Here's your Lucas aid, Geoffrey.
Sip it now, don't gulp.
It's a blessing in disguise, this, really. At least I can work on my stand-up comedy material now.
No, you can't. You need to rest.
Oh, Helen, read to me. Read me my letters from the stand-up comedians.
Okey-dokey. Dear Jeff, how tickled I was to receive your tatifilarious letter. Your jokes were quite discomnocorating. Good luck with your comedy career from the Diddy Men and all at Knotty Ash.
Who's that from?
Oh, it's from Ken Dodd, Jeffy.
I knew that.
How's the patient?
Hello, Lizzie. What's he doing here?
Thought we'd lost you back there, big guy. Made me think about how I'd treated you in the past.
Yeah?
At times, you must have thought I hated you.
Well, yes, I did.
Good, just wanted to be absolutely sure I've been clear.
What did the doctor say?
It's a virus. He probably picked it up on his hospital visits.
I knew I felt funny. Then I'm a clown. I always feel funny.
Look at that. Still cracking jokes, even in his sick bed.
What are you looking for, Erasmus?
I was just wondering if there was some sort of machine we could unplug.
It's good news and bad news, isn't it, Geoffrey? He'll be confined to bed for some time.
But what's the bad news?
He'll be out of action for at least a week.
What's the bad news?
He won't be able to perform.
Right. What's the bad news?
He won't be able to do the clown act.
What's the bad news?
This is affecting my blood pressure.
What's the bad news?
Erasmus.
I want to get him a get well present. Is there anything he's allergic to?
Not really.
Even if it's really rare, I don't mind shopping round for it.
What will you do, Lizzie? Will you have to shut the circus down for a week?
No, we'll scrape along without you, Uncle Jeff.
But you can't have a circus without clowns. It'd be like having a meal without
salmonella.
But we've got a clown, Auntie Helen.
Oh, that's a good one. She's crap without me. No offence, look.
He's right. There's no Plinky without Plonky.
Right, well, we'll have to audition someone new then. That's it, is it, Boyko? That's your clown act. You laughing at a pie.
It's difficult for me, but I know what is coming.
We all know what's coming. You stick the pie in Helen's face.
How'd you guys keep a straight face?
Boyko, it's a no.
I have little doubt. I'll never be able to forgive myself.
Naho!
You should have come to me first, Lizzie. In 1976, I was Razzmatazz the Clown. I can start today.
Oh, you're a lifesaver. Why did you stop being Razzmatazz the Clown?
Well, for some bizarre reason, it was considered politically incorrect. Couldn't understand the fuss myself. Anyway, I need some bongo drums, a large tin of boot polish, and a bone this big.
Right, Helen, I'm sorry, but you'll be doing the clown act on your own.
Oh, I can't, Lizzie, not without a partner.
Well, Boyko can't do it. I can't let Georgie revive the black and white minstrels.
It's called old-fashioned family entertainment.
It's called old-fashioned racism, Georgie, and I can't let you do it.
Fascist.
I can't do the act on my own, Lizzie. I'm no good.
You are. You're hilarious.
Well, I've never heard you laugh at us.
You know when you laugh so hard that no sound comes out?
Yes, we get a lot of that sort of laughter.
And I see your act every day, so I know it really well.
Then why don't you do it with me? I know how much you want to have a circus skill.
What, you'd really let me play Plonky to your Plinky?
Yes! I mean, obviously you wouldn't do it to Jeff's standard.
Oh, God, no.
Well, let's do it!
Yes, how exciting! Let's practice.
Oh! Lizzie! Are we now so poor? You are drinking petrol.
No, why'd you ask?
The petrol for my flaming somersault routine. It has gone missing.
Oh, who would steal? Oh, God. What did I say about playing with fire?
It's safe. I'm a convicted arsonist. I know what I'm doing.
That's very reassuring, but I told you, no insurance fraud.
It's not fraud. It'll be a real fire.
I've got a better solution. A fantastic new clown act.
Me?
Trust me, this way will be less painful for everyone.
Give it a chance. It could be amazing.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, now prepare yourselves for some knockout laughs at Plinky and Plonky's boxing match!
Sure.
Yeah. Harder than that. Harder!
I'm so sorry, golly. Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Oh, I think I just lost a contact lens.
Oh, you're bleeding.
I'm fine. It's ketchup. Ketchup.
What did you think? Boyko?
I have not the words. It's how you say when...
Stop pretending you can't speak English.
Okay, I cannot lie, Lizzie. Whoo, you are crap.
We had teething problems. It was my first show.
Lizzie, you are even worse than Jeff.
Oh, that's a lovely thing to say. Geoffrey will be thrilled.
Thanks for the vote of confidence. Georgie, how were the takings?
We took £300.
Oh, that's not bad.
And had to refund £200 after you were clown act.
So, £100?
Which I've given to David.
Sorry, you've given all our profits to the dog?
He'll struggle to find a new profession when we go out of business.
We're not going out of business.
Lizzie, I've seen your act. There was a time when every circus wanted David. But one day you wake up, and your little hind legs aren't as supple as they were, and suddenly no one returns your calls.
We are still talking about the dog.
So, I'm as bad at clowning as I am at everything else. OK. No more Lizzie the Clown.
It's nothing personal, Lizzie. It's just that you have absolutely no talent whatsoever.
And, young man, I believe you could have a very promising career in stand-up comedy. And there's more. Jimmy Cricket.
Oh, afternoon, ladies. How was your debut performance?
It was OK.
Oh, it was terrible. Geoffrey, we made a complete mess of things.
Yes.
We weren't that bad. We had injury problems.
Oh, Helen. What have I told you? Even when it bleeds, you keep punching, keep punching. Kids love it.
What's my first day as Plonky the Clown?
You can't call yourself Plonky. I'm Plonky. That's identity theft.
I'm not using it to apply for credit.
People have a certain respect for the name Plonky. I don't want you turning it into a laughingstock.
There's no danger of that.
And besides, well, I'm not being sexist, but...
What?
Women can't do comedy.
What?
Name me one successful female comedian.
Victor!
See, you can't do it. Well, all right, then. Dame Edna. But she doesn't count. Because she is Australian. See, people should stick to what they know, and in your case, that's going to the office and doing your typing.
Right, Helen, we're back on tonight.
Oh, do we have to be?
And I will damn well show you what a good female clown is all about.
Mm. Yes, it is extremely tight-fitting.
Right, I've got one day to find a brand new clown routine.
Yes, the sweat makes it stick to my body. Very uncomfortable.
Sorry, what are you doing?
Raising extra funds for the circus. Yes, I would like to peel it off myself and feel the air against my naked skin.
So, you're raising funds for the circus by running a premium rate chat line?
Of course not.
It's a very reasonable rate, isn't it?
Yes. It is for people who are interested in the circus and circus performers and wish to discuss this with...
Boyko the sweaty acrobat who loves to perform.
That's me.
And they pay 70 pence a minute, half of which goes in profit to the circus.
Carry on.
Hello.
Lizzie, I need help organising sponsors for David.
What for?
He's going to swim the English Channel.
What a guy!
You can't make David swim the Channel.
I can't stop him. Just look at the determination in his eyes. And if I hook his lead to the back of a speedboat, we can be in Cali in less than half an hour.
You all to tighten your belts, and you respond by opening a chat line, trying to burn down the circus, and drowning a dog.
Thinking outside the box.
Right, start from scratch. I want you to forget everything you ever knew about clowning.
Okay, done that.
Forget Plinky and Plonky. From now on, we are Plinky and Planky.
Gosh. This is so much information for me to take on board.
Try to stay with me. Right. Now, I thought a purple wig might be funny. What do you think?
I don't know if you like.
No, come on, you all have an opinion.
No, I'm not. If I suggest things, Geoffrey says it contaminates his genius.
OK. Well, I'm not a genius, so suggest things.
Well, I don't know,
Go on.
Well, I was thinking if, you had normal size boxing gloves on, then if I come on in the big ones, that might be funnier, probably not.
Oh, that might work.
Then if I came on from the back, the kids would see me before you did, and they might like that. Well,
then perhaps I could...
What's that noise?
It is the sound of children's laughter.
Can't be, the clowns are on.
Yes, watch!
Well, I never...
Makes me not want to burn down the circus.
Yeah, they are okay, but for me, Jeff is still the world's number one clown.
That's because you can't count.
He'll be back in the ring soon, then you will see.
Not if I can stop him.
Nothing can stop Jeff. You'd have to drug him unconscious to keep him away.
Two of these, four times a day, and we're laughing.
As if I'm going to take them from you. They're probably poison or something.
I won't lie to you, Jeff. These are zebra tranquilizers. Very dangerous to human beings.
I knew it. So I'm not going to take them. So what are you going to do now?
Same thing they do when the zebras won't take them.
Oh, what are you doing? That's a tranquilizer dart.
Well spotted. Should keep you out of action for a few more days.
That show needs me. Lizzie and Helen are dying out there.
You think? How was the show, Helen?
Oh, it was wonderful. I mean, it's such a magical thing to capture a child's imagination, isn't it, Geoffrey?
How would he know?
So you did all right, then?
No. No. Not very well.
But he seems to think you're better off without me.
No, 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 Geoffrey. God, Erasmus just likes undermining people's confidence.
Yes, yes, he does. So, were you crap?
Yes.
Were you terrible? Really terrible?
Oh, we were awful, Geoffrey. We need you fit and well as soon as possible.
Yes, well, I could probably go on tomorrow and... If...
Not rush things. Get your rest.
No, Helen, I'm fine. Look, I'm...
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm just a little tired.
Look, if you're overdoing it on those chat lines, you should take a night off.
No, no, I am tired from working the overnight shift at Tesco Metro. Hey, anything to raise circus funds?
When did you last sleep?
Hey, do not worry. I had a little nap a few minutes ago.
Really? Where?
On the high wire.
It's ridiculous. You're working far too hard. I insist that you drink... lots more black coffee on tonight's shift at the supermarket.
Nice clown in there, Plinky.
Oh, thank you very much, Erasmus.
I bet it's eating Jeff up inside, is it?
Well, I haven't really told him as such.
You haven't told him?
Well, actually, he's been asleep all afternoon for some reason, curled up in the fetal position, all sweaty and shouting something about zebras.
You have to tell him this is your big moment.
Well, you know how sensitive Geoffrey is. I mean, if he knew how well we were getting on, he'd... Well, he might never come back.
Yeah. That would be terrible, wouldn't it? Just a little present to say, you know, I apologise for injecting you with zebra tranquilizers.
What? Well, I suppose I get an electric shock when I switch it on.
It's hooked up to the monitors in the big top, so you can see how badly we're doing without you.
Right. Well, OK. Well, thanks.
And you get an electric shock when you switch it on.
Great. Meet me in my office in 10 minutes.
Okie dokie. Yeah. Geoffrey! What are you doing out of bed?
Good show, was it?
No. Oh, no, it was another stinker, I'm afraid. Oh, we were lucky to escape with our lives.
Really?
Yeah, yeah. We need you back in that room, Geoffrey. Everyone's been saying so.
Helen. I've been thinking, and I've made a decision.
Boyko, I'll be honest. I'm concerned. Boyko. Boyko.
Clear up in R14, customer spillage!
Hey, do you have a club card, madam?
You look terrible. I'm concerned and I really admire everything you're doing. Keep up the good work. Uncle Jeff, you're up. Oh, God, you're not well, are you?
What?
I mean, oh, God, you're not well, are you? Get back to bed. The health of my performers is paramount. Don't mind him. He's having a lie down.
Jeff's got something to tell you, Lizzie.
I'm leaving. I'm going to hang up my clown costume for good. Hook up with some of those comedians who've been after me. Don't try and talk me out of this, Lizzie.
No. I mean, no. Your mind's clearly made up.
What's happening?
Don't say a word. Uncle Jeff has very sadly announced his retirement.
Yeah.
You can only spoil this.
I'm very sorry to hear your bad news.
Well done.
Well, we'll pack up our things and we'll be gone this time tomorrow.
Right, well, if that's what you think... Sorry, we? You're not going, are you, Auntie Helen?
Of course I am, Lizzie. I'm his wife.
Well, you can be his wife and still be a clown.
No, me and Geoffrey are a team. We'll make his sandwiches for him and shave his back.
See? She needs me.
You can't leave me, Auntie Helen. I can't go on without Plinky. I need you.
Not as much as Geoffrey does. He's lost all his confidence. I just don't know why.
One of life's great mysteries, that.
Uncle Jeff will be fine. He's got all those letters from big shot comedians to follow up.
No, Lizzie, I write those letters.
What?
Geoffrey gets so gloomy when the comedians don't reply, and they never do, or worse. They write things like this.
Dear Jeff, stop sending me your unfunny material. It stinks. You're a talentless piece of... Ooh, the language.
That's Joe Pasquale for you. So, I write the replies and it seems to keep him happy.
But what will you do? Where will you go?
Well, we'll be all right. We've got each other.
Come on, you. My clothes won't pack themselves. Oh, one more thing. Please, no fuss, no leaving card, and definitely no party.
Whatever you say, buddy. You're the boss.
I did actually say no party.
You still here? Sorry, I meant to start the celebrations after you left.
That's thoughtful, isn't it, Geoffrey?
Got any last requests, yeah? I've got Smokey Robinson, Tears of a Clown, Kinks, Death of a Clown, Hooray, Hooray, the talentless fat clown is out of our lives forever. I'll have one myself.
I thought you'd give it a rest, just this once.
Sorry, Jeff, can't help it if this is the happiest day of my life.
Excuse me?
What?
Looking for Plunky the Clown?
That's me.
I saw you in the hospital. All the doctors said it wouldn't get better. But then, Plunky the Clown came to visit me and made me laugh.
Really?
And then I did get better. Thank you, Plunky.
Wow, what a story.
What a lot of old balls.
Geoffrey.
Come on, get lost, kid.
But Plunky, I love you.
Sorry, fuck off.
Geoff, what are you doing?
I'm not stupid. I know I wind up when I see one.
I don't know what you're talking about. You've just taken a very sick, sweet child and been mean to him.
Was that okay?
Shh.
Do I get my £20 now?
Okay, so that specific child wasn't in the hospital, but he's symbolic of children everywhere.
Enough's enough. I'm gonna get the bags. Come on, Alex.
What the hell was that?
It was the only way I could think of to keep Auntie Helen. Have you got a minute, Uncle Jeff?
Come to sing me a song, have you? Hooray, the clown is gone forever.
No. I've come to tell you that you're hilarious. Much better than me and Helen.
Save it. I saw the show. I heard those kids laughing.
No, you didn't.
Yes, I did, and I'll never forget that sound. Children's laughter. Ooh, it goes right through me.
Did it sound anything like this? Erasmus set it up. It's not real children's laughter. It was a sound effect. The real children thought we were rubbish. They want their Plonky back.
And you believe that I have a responsibility to those children?
You have a duty to your talent.
To my genius, yes. I am Plonky the Clown and this circus needs me.
And in a few days when you're...
Balls to a few days. I'm better now and I'm getting back in that ring.
What? No, me and Helen can manage.
No, you've tried your best, Lizzie, and I appreciate that. But these kids deserve better. They deserve a professional. Here comes Plonky.
Ladies and gentlemen, your attention, please. David successfully completed his channel swim this afternoon. So please have your cash ready.
Hey, well done, David! Woo!
Thank you, Boyko. Did I mention his sponsored free-fall parachute jump next week?
No, great. I have money.
Boyko, you don't have that much money.
Yes, I have been promised £6,000. I'm selling something over the internet.
Is it one of your kidneys?
Yes.
Boyko, it's time to draw the line.
No. They have already drawn it. Look.
I forbid you to sell your body parts.
But, Lizzie, the circus is in trouble.
Not anymore, Bonko. Dr. Plonky's back in business.
Jeffrey, really?
Absolutely. You've let those kids down for long enough, and now it's my turn.
Hi, everyone. The party has become a welcome home. Let's hear it for Jeff, my man. Woo! Woo! I'll get the drinks.
I'll get the dark gum.
Now, Jeff's back, so the crisis is over. There's no need for you to sell your kidneys, all right?
Okay.
We're going back to my caravan for dinner.
Oh, Jeffrey, I'm so glad that we're not leaving anymore.
Of course not. I am an artiste, and you can't switch that off.
Listen, and I actually tried some new ideas while you were
there. That's smashing.
And I was thinking that maybe we could...
Shush! Forget all that. We're going back to the classics. Shall we hit each other, boys and girls? Shall we? Plonky can't hear you! Seriously, I actually can't hear you. Shall we hit each other? Thank you. See, at least someone's awake.
The police want answers and all fingers point to Janine. EastEnders next on BBC One and Strictly Terrified. Dancer Darren Bennett finally takes the weight off his feet. The Black Chair returns. Celebrity Mastermind at 8:30.
Your best man?
Her name's Vanessa. She's on her way.
Are you excited?
I am, yeah. It feels very emotional.
Will it be a tidy ever after? Yeah! Gavin and Stacey, the final episode. New Year's Day at 9 on BBC One.
Sometimes I feel like throw my hands up in the air. I can count on you. You got the love. You got the love. You got the love.
Fantastic.
That was all right. What about your ballet, your tap, your jazz?
Nigel and Arlene put the best to the test. So you think you can dance. Start Saturday at 6 on BBC One.